I come in the power and grace of the Lord God to invest within you each one the radiance of spirit manifest as living fire. For when you experience this living fire, you, blessed ones, are transformed in that grace of God, which is violet and which brings you into the domain of the saints of heaven, the ascended masters, the hosts of the Lord, the great archangels and the archai, the Elohim and all cosmic beings. Do you desire to live in heavenly grace for the rest of your life? As you have requested it, so it shall be if you accept the presence of what is holy deep within you, who is God. God is spirit. God is light. God is love. And I am the witness of that light and love and spirit fire. Now within these initiates, these disciples of the word, O Lord. And now I bring that fire, that fire, that fire unto each one within the dynamic of planetary transmutation, whereby first Mexico is enfired by this light, by this joy, by this hallowed crystalline matrix of perfection. And as I place many, many, many aspects of this fire throughout this people and this nation, so there will be cosmic change, so there may be a type of spiritual revolution come, whereby those who are pure and true, noble and divinely oriented will take their place to overthrow those who have misused the light, those who have manipulated the system to the detriment of all peoples of this nation and all nations. I proclaim a revolution of spirit this day, not of violence, yet what will bring forth a great, mysterious, yet majestic, and powerful dynamic into the world. And it is up to each and every one of you, dearest hearts, to be the center point of that spiritual revolution through a heart enfired by God's love, enfired by God's light, enfired by God's joy. Are you the loving light and the loving joy of the Holy Spirit, blessed hearts? Then allow that joy to speak into the teeth of evil and darkness and say, you have no power over me, O you evil and denying spirit of God. Burn through, O sacred fire. Burn through, O sacred fire. Burn through, burn through, burn through, and eradicate all evil, all hexes, curses, incantations of darkness, all black magic, witchcraft, juju, necromancy. You have no power over this people to promote your evil ways. You have no power over my nation, the beautiful, heartfelt citizens of Mexico. I am here as a witness to the Holy Spirit's presence throughout this nation, and I declare that change is the order of the day, that transformation is the new standard and the new norm. And I am that standard of light. I am that standard of joy. I am that standard of graciousness and the empowerment of that spirit that delivers light, light, light into every situation. Love, love, love into all that is dark, dense, dank, and decrepit. Yes, I am the aliveness of the Holy Spirit, the legitimacy of that spirit's power and facility to ease and comfort the downtrodden and to overthrow those who have brought their drugs and their cartel evil into play within this nation and many nations. They have no power over this people. And now you will see by the hosts of the Lord that come in answer to this empowering love, the overthrowing of many who have brought forth this darkness, both at the border and throughout this nation. You will see the arresting, the incarceration, and the judgment of those who have been behind all that is dark, that has swept across the northern part of this nation and brought its darkness and evil into the United States of America and other nations. Dearest ones, by God's grace, because of your calls to Archangel Michael and the hosts of the Lord, I am empowered to come this day in this group dynamic and soul-raising session to raise the souls of all of God's children within this nation and to empower them to be dynamically opposed to that evil and to cast it out of this nation. Will you cast it out day after day, blessed ones, through your holy fiats of fire?
Yes.
Thus you can stand in your offices, in your homes, and say, by the power of the Holy Spirit, I cast out these evil spirits, these evil individuals, especially in the cartels and those who are trafficking people and drugs throughout this nation and into the United States. I cast them out now by the power of the I Am name of God. I cast them out by the power of Archangel Michael and the seven archangels and their archii. I cast them out in the name I Am that I Am and in the name of the blessed Jesus, the living Christ. You see, blessed ones, it will take new and more powerful determination for you to take control of this economy, take control of this government, take control of this nation. And if you choose to stand with the Holy Spirit, to stand with the Ascended Masters, we will stand with you. We will charge forth that light through you. We will deliver what heaven's graces are truly made of, which is pure compassion, pure kindness, pure joy, and all of these Venusian graces and virtues that you have just invoked, dearest ones. If you believe that these virtues can be yours, so it is, and so you may incorporate them into your heart, into your life, into your daily affairs, and there can be such a dynamic, transformational change that within 3 years' time, Mexico will truly be a new cultural nation of light and love, understanding, joy, and holy purpose. It begins with each and every one who is determined to be an empowered one by the grace of God. And as you choose this empowerment, as you revel in this light, as you invoke it daily and drink it in, yes, eat that fire and drink that light. So it shall be your daily food from heaven, your manna from the divine world. And as that light grows within you, your auras will expand. You will become much more spiritually powerful, and your calls will go forth north, south, east, and west to transform every aspect of this culture, this civilization. Yet it requires faith, dearest ones. It requires faith. That God is the doer. You are not the doer. God in you is the doer and the door to the light. And if you believe this, if you accept it, then you shall see many, many, many changes and the good people rising up to cast away that darkness and that evil. As you were traveling in your buses during these little jaunts throughout this portion of your nation, dearest ones, the messenger saw what was not optimal for the lives of the people living here. And he saw how many have abandoned God in their life. They no longer go to church or pray whatsoever. They are engaged in materialism just as much as other nations that have much more material wealth. So I, the Holy Spirit, am calling the people of Mexico back to the heart of the Virgin of Guadalupe, back to holy prayer, sacrifice, givingness, and confession. And if you confess your sins, your karmic imprints of the denial of God within your nation and your people and your own life, then God will turn your hearts to greater good, and you shall see that person by person, the great people of Mexico who have that love of God in their hearts will inspire others to lead godly lives above and beyond what is the standard these days. There are many, many, many holy citizens of this nation who pray the rosary daily, who call to the Virgin of Guadalupe with their entire being to cure the ills of society, to save the children, oh, the precious children, from the drug traffickers and the human traffickers. Yet, dearest ones, it will take an even greater groundswell of holy prayer, where your churches will be filled to overflowing with those who are devoted to this cultural transformational change. And you must be the leaders and even go into these churches, empowered by the Holy Spirit, to pray with all of your might and to give forth selflessly that spirit of divine love that will bring God into play within this world in such a powerful and inspirational matrix that your life now will truly be magical, metamorphized into the divine world. O holy ones, I know that I am partly speaking to the choir, for you are a choir of angels in embodiment. And yet, who else can I go to in this hour to charge forth this light into their very beings, to raise their souls into the divine world, and to allow them to feel the impulses of God deep within their bloodstream, deep within the cells of their own consciousness, and to then be the leaders who they are destined to be, to lead this nation and all of humanity into the Aquarian age. If you would be a leader, then sacrifice more, give selflessly, be a good shepherd, a servant leader in the truest sense as Jesus modeled it. And then you will be the one through whom the light will flow, the inspiration will grow, and many will be changed in the twinkling of an eye. You have heard this gospel quote, that all shall be transformed in the twinkling of an eye. Well, what is that twinkling, dearest ones? It is pure vision now manifest for your nation, for your people, for your world. And when you have that pure vision of Mary, that immaculate concept of all to be pure, real, holy, and true, then as you shine it forth and blaze it forth through your third eye, so it is manifest, and you shall see in the twinkling of your greater God eye, the all-seeing eye, this vision of light, of beauty, of harmony, of peace. And it shall sweep across the nation, and all shall be as brothers and sisters again, without conflict, without the drama of karma manifesting between them. Imagine a world where everyone gets along perfectly. Brothers and sisters within families, brothers and sisters within communities of light, holy ones who put God first in their life. This will be what transforms all, dearest hearts. And you can do it. I say you can do it if you try, as Saint Germain says. Try, try, and try again. And even if you falter and fall down and scratch your knee, your Divine Mother will comfort you, dry your tears, inspire you to get up again and enter into the divine battle for good again and again until you are a conquering hero or heroine for God. You see, blessed ones, This soul-raising session is now a call to divine arms. It is a call to planetary transformational change. And if you in Mexico have the hearts that are full of largesse, in other words, you have very large heart chakras because you feel deeply inside of you the truth, the way, and the life of the Christ. If you will model this for all of humanity, then this action will sweep across the nations, north, south, east, and west, all the Americas, all of Europe, all of Africa, all of Asia, all of Australia and the islands, throughout the Pacific and the Atlantic. And you shall see a golden new world as your heart form for this year has proclaimed it. And what is that golden world? It is a world rich in those who, as per what Jesus has shared, live a golden life, following the golden rule. You see, this was predestined, this heart form for this year, and Jesus' message followed Gautama Buddha's message about how to make this world golden. Golden, 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 I proclaim it. I, the Holy Spirit, envision it. And you can too, blessed hearts, if you have the will and the virya, the strength of character to make it so. Some of you have given so selflessly that you almost have nothing left in your bank accounts. And many never had much in their bank accounts anyway. Yet, dearest ones, the more that you give from your heart, through your will, united with God, the greater the empowerment of that givingness to bring about that change and that holy transformation. So this day, I desire the messenger to stand before you and for you to come forth each one individually and receive a blessing upon your crown chakra by me, the Holy Spirit. And I will fire you, I will empower you, I will etch within your soul matrices and engrams of light, so that after this event, you will not forget my words to you. You will have them so permanently burnished within you that you cannot help but each day arise with greater joy and greater fire to be the one through whom God emanates this great light, this great empowering energy of spirit. Will you, dearest ones, proclaim your promise, your vow to me, that you will never forget this session and that you will be an empowered one moving forward for the rest of your life to be a godly spirit for God?
Yes.
Then come forth and receive my blessing upon you, and then go forth silently from this place for your brief respite, returning in 20 or 30 minutes, whatever is required, to prepare for the coming of the Master Padre Pio with his great message of light for you. Thank you, blessed hearts, for being here, being receptive, and being the hearts through whom I can speak and emanate and bless all. Thank you.
Please.
Thank you.
Please.
Please.
Blaze.
Blaze through.